Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In our last video, we discussed CD4081, that is AND gate. This IC, it is CMOS AND gate. It have two inputs, one output. In that video, we checked that it have four gates. 1, 2, 3, 4, pin 14 VDD, pin 7, ground voltage, return line. And this IC, CD4011, it have also four gates, but it have NAND gates. The function of AND gate, that if any input or all inputs are low, the output will low. Output will high just only in one condition, when both inputs will high. It is a condition. In this IC CD4011, it have four gates. So it have two inputs, A, B, and Y. So Y, it is inverted output. Here it was regular output. Let's see its truth table. A, B, Y. So Y is inverted here, A dot B, and then inverted function. So 0 if one input is low, second is high, the output will high because it will provide opposite output to this gate. If A is high, B is low, if both inputs are low, if A is high, B is low, the output is high. If both inputs are low, the output is high. If both inputs are high, the output will low. Here is CD4081 and here is CD4011. It comes in MC4011, CD4011, HEF4011. So different numbers, but the generic number is 4011. Pin number 14, that is positive input supply voltage. Pin number 14 and pin number 14 will connect it to positive supply. And pin number 7 and pin number 7, we will power up both ICs together. 7 and 7 together. And we will turn on just only one gate. If we check the pin out, pin 1 input, 2 input, 3 is output for the first gate. 4 output, 5, 6 input, 7 ground, 9, 8 and 9 input, 10 output, 13 and 12 input, 11 output. So we will take output from pin number 11. We will turn on just only one gate. The other gates will work in the same way. So this is, I connected pin number 11 to the output LED. So we will compare function of both ICs together. Now we will apply input. We will combine both inputs together so we can compare the function. 13 together, 12 together, and we will bring 13 and 12 to input point. This is now input. Yes, that's good. These two are input pins. So this input will reach here and this input will also reach here. The output of this IC is here. Output of this IC is here. This is AND and this is NAND. We will connect ground to the ground point, and we will connect ground to these resistors which we connected here, anode of LED, resistor and ground. And here we will apply positive voltage. So positive voltage will connect it here at positive pin, and we will apply ground here and positive here. So our test circuit is ready now. This is AND. Now if we will connect both inputs to ground, this IC will turn off its output. And its output is high. When both inputs are open, both LEDs are on. Why? Because this time the IC is in floating mode. When inputs are open in TTL or CMOS, when the both inputs are open, that are called floating inputs, and IC cannot determine what is the voltage level. First condition, both inputs are low, this is zero volt, and this IC, it have high output. Now if I will connect one input to high, A is high, B is low, output is low, but here output is high. If I will connect second to high and first to low, A low, B high, output is high. Now if I will connect both inputs to the positive side, both inputs are high, this IC have high output, but this IC is giving low output. So these are providing opposite function. So in the logic circuits, when there is a condition that we need to compare two inputs, one is high, the second is high, the output will high. This is function of this IC. And this IC, it will compare when both inputs are high, the output will low. Opposite. If anyone is low, if anyone or both inputs are low, the output is low. But here, if anyone input is low or all inputs are low, the output will high. If both inputs are high here, output is low. And here is opposite. So AND gate, NAND gate. Now we connected our test line here. 13, 12 and 11. Now we can apply input to pin number 8, 9, and we can take output from pin number 10. Okay, I will connect. This is output pin, and I will connect the inputs to pin number 8 and 9. We will not do anything here because it is AND function. We are testing the NAND function. Both inputs are high, the output is low. Anyone input is low, the output will high. If one signal level will go to high, the other is low, the output is high. Now we will swap the leads. We can see if both inputs are high, the output is high here, but here is low. If anyone is low, A or B, any input or both inputs are low, the output will high. So it is providing the function like this. Same way we can test this IC in this side. We can provide input at 5 and 6. Pin number 4 is output. 1, 2 input, pin A and B. Pin number 3 is output. So it has 4 gates. Each gate is independent from the others. Just only power supply is common for all, positive and ground, but the function of the gates is separate from each one. If we change the inputs from high to low, low to high, with this truth table combination and the IC does not change the output status, that means the IC is damaged. Let's check the voltage. This is the ground line. We can see this pin, it have 5.1 volt, and this one 0 volt. One is low, second is high, the output is high. Okay, let me connect to, now I will move both pins to high, 5 volt, 5 volt, the output is low. When both inputs are high, high means logic level high, 5 volt, 5 volt, output is low. If anyone or both inputs are low, the output will high. This is the NAND function. This is low, this is low, the output is high. It is inverted function for after combining two inputs using AND function, then it will convert to NAND function. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.